Hello learners, welcome to our Senior Secondary Environmental Science course of NIOS. Environmentalists are now alarmed and deeply concerned about proof degrading global environment, the expression of this degradation in conspicuous as we experience climate change and disasters like cyclone, tsunami, cloudburst, etc. To address environmental issues for protecting environment by analyzing and monitoring against misuse and to make environment sustainable, organization have set up. This program is based on environmental institutions and organization and which is lesson 25 of module 7 of environmental science course. The various national and international institutions and organizations which have been working in, which have been working to spread out awareness and to conserve the environment for future generation. I am Neelam Gupta, course coordinator of environmental science. Welcome to this program of NIOS. For this discussion, we have with us Dr. Rita Kushla, associate professor from Zakir Hussain, Delhi College, University of Delhi. Welcome you this program, madam.
Thank you, Neelam. Environmental protection has become headline news in every country of the world. The reason is it has become a matter of urgent global concern because of consequences of climate change, ozone depletion, pollution, etc. General public has become aware that it is harmful to use plastic, burn wood or garden waste, hunt animals or cut trees, or burn crackers during festivals and throw garbage in rivers. This awareness has come because of the efforts of environmental organizations about which we will discuss today. So the objectives of the programs are environmental administration in India through institutions and ministries of Indian government, role and responsibilities of global institutions in environmental management and sustainable development, role of United Nations, UN, and its body in environmental safekeeping. Several international organizations, ecological movements, and NGOs have emerged to deal with the above objectives. An environmental organization is an organization that protects, analyzes, or monitors the environment against misuse or degradation. Environmental organization can be of three levels. They can be a civil society, national, or international. In national, again, there are three divisions: government, non-government, which is also known as NGO, and charitable trust. International environmental organizations, the ones which are very popular these days, are the government and non-government ones. In government, in India, we have MOEF, CCC, CPCB, IBWL. In international, we have UNEP, IUCN, UNCED, UNFCCC, WHO, FAO, and CST. Now, coming to non-governmental organizations in India, the popular ones are CSC, NMNH, BNHS, Development Alternatives, TERI, Kalpvriksh, Sulabh International. Whereas international level, the NGOs are WWF, Greenpeace, Friends of Earth, etc. Now, coming to historical background to environmental movements, India's consciousness to protect the environment and to restore it exists since the early days of civilization. However, in modern days, because of high priority to economic growth, environment receded to a less important place. The awareness of environmental crisis originated in the world in early 60s, and this began when Raquel Carson, a US citizen, created public awareness about the harmful effects of pesticide pollution through her book Silent Spring. This book was responsible for creation of environment awareness and environment protection laws not only in US but all over the world. Environmental institutions in India. In India, for the first time in 1972, National Committee on Environmental Planning and Coordination was constituted, NCEPC. 1985, it was upgraded to Ministry of Environment and Forest, MOEF. Now it is renamed as Ministry of Environment, Forests and Climate Change, MOEFCC. MOEFCC is the nodal agency of UNEP in India with headquarters in New Delhi. It is the administrative structure of the central government for environmental programs of all sorts in the country. The main activities undertaken by MOEF include conservation and survey of flora and fauna of India by Botanical Survey of India, BSI, and Zoological Survey of India, ZSI. Next is prevention and control of pollution, afforestation and reducing land degradation. It also undertakes administration of the national parks of India. Central Pollution Control Board, CPCB, is an organization which was constituted in September 1974 under the Water Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1974 and Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1981. It also provides technical services to the Ministry of Environment. Now, what are the principal functions of CPCB? They are control and abatement of water pollution, to improve the quality of air, and to prevent, control or abate air pollution in the country. It also coordinates the activity of the various state boards and resolves water disputes among different states of India. The Central Pollution Control Board, CPCB, and the State Pollution Control Board, SPCBs, are the pollution supervisory bodies in India. CPCB runs nationwide programs of ambient air quality monitoring known as National Air Quality Monitoring Program. National Air Quality Index was launched in 2014 to give information on air quality. Environmental Governance and State Pollution Control Board. In India, states do not pursue independent environmental policy of their own, but adopt the policies formulated at the national level. Indian Board of Wildlife, IBWL, is an apex advisory body in the field of wildlife conservation in the country and is headed by Honorable Prime Minister of India. The IBL has been reconstituted and renamed as National Board for Wildlife, NBWL, on 22nd September 2003 under Section 5 of Wildlife Protection Act 1972. After discussing national level organization in India, now we will discuss international level of environmental organizations. UNEP, United Nations Environment Programme, was created in 1972 as an outgrowth of the United Nations Conference on the Human Environment, which was held in Stockholm in 1972. It has headquarters in Nairobi, Kenya. UNEP's main mandate is to coordinate the development of environmental policy for the whole world. UNEP has played a significant role in developing international environmental conventions such as Montreal Convention for Ozone Depletion, Earth Summit for Diverse Environment Issues, UNFCCC, Kyoto Protocol, and IPCC for Climate Change, and IUCN for Conservation of Resources. UNEP has also been active in funding environment-related projects such as solar program in India and many other countries. Earth Summit, the United Nations Conference on Environment and Development, UNCED, was an important international event also known as the Earth Summit. It was held in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil in June 1992. Presidents and prime ministers of 172 nations attended the conference along with the NGOs and made this conference a huge international success. The main outcomes of the Earth Summit were incorporated in five documents, which are Convention on Climate Change, UNFCCC, Convention on Biological Diversity, CBD, Statement on Forest Principles, Rio Declaration, and lastly, Agenda 21. UNFCCC, the full form is United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. This was adopted at the Earth Summit. The aim of UNFCCC is to stabilize the concentration of greenhouse gases which are responsible for global warming and to keep global warming of the world below 2 degrees C. Otherwise, it will lead to submergence of many coastal cities and countries. The convention has annual conference of parties known as COP to review the implementation of its objective every year. The Kyoto Protocol, a legally binding agreement to reduce greenhouse gases, was adopted in 1997 in Kyoto, Japan by UNFCCC and was started working from 16 February 2005. USA, despite being the largest emitter of greenhouse gases, did not ratify the protocol. India signed and ratified the protocol in August 2002. In COP3, which the Kyoto Protocol was adopted in 1997, as per Kyoto Protocol, industrialized countries had to reduce the greenhouse gas emission by 5.2% of their 1990 level by the end of the first commitment period 2008 to 2012, whereas developing countries such as India and China were exempted from emission targets. The emission targets of different countries are given here in this table. Like Canada, minus 6, that means Canada had to decrease the emission of greenhouse gases by 6%. European Union, minus 8. Switzerland, minus 8. Norway, plus 1. Norway is a carbon-free country and they did not have to reduce the greenhouse gases. In fact, they were allowed plus 1. And Australia, plus 8. Commission on Sustainable Development, CSD, was established in December 1992 as part of Earth Summit held in Rio de Janeiro. The mandate of CSD are to monitor progress on the implementation of Agenda 21 in accordance with the Article 68 of the Charter of the UN of Earth Summit for Sustainable Development. Also, to aid financing and transfer of technologies as outlined in Agenda 21. CITES, Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Fauna and Flora. This is UN organization, controls the export and import of plants and animals. The main aim of CITES is to conserve biodiversity and endangered plants and animals. International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources, IUCN, is the world's oldest global environmental network. It has wide membership of governments, NGOs, and scientists from more than 160 countries. The IUCN headquarters are located in Gland, near Geneva, in Switzerland. The main functions of IUCN are: it runs thousands of field projects around the world to better manage natural environments. IUCN supports international conventions, UN organizations to develop laws and policy, and helps by providing resources and also training people. International national level NGOs. Some of the international NGOs such as Global Footprint Network, Friends of the Earth, Greenpeace, WWF are working for environmental problems all over the world. Some of the noted NGOs of India are Bombay Natural History Society, Center for Science and Environment, Development Alternatives, Chintan, Kalpvriksh, etc. World Wide Fund for Nature, WWF, is an NGO dedicated to building a healthy living planet for the future generation. WWF was formed on September 11, 1961 in Morges, Switzerland under the name World Wildlife Fund. This name has been changed in 1986 and now it has become White Fund for Nature, retaining the WWF initials. WWF is working in more than 90 countries, supporting large number of conservation and environmental projects around the world. WWF is working towards protection of polar bear and several other endangered animals. The Living Planet Report is a magazine published by WWF every 2 years. The giant panda, an endangered species, is the symbol of WWF, which is shown here. Greenpeace. In 1971, Greenpeace was founded in US, and the founder of Greenpeace had a vision of green and peaceful world. Their mission was to oppose US underground nuclear testing in Antarctica. Nuclear testing ended that same year, and the island Antarctica was later declared a bird sanctuary. Center for Science and Environment, CSE, is a Delhi-based NGO, was established in 1980. CSE makes people aware about various environmental programs of the country through their publications. The CSE has been working on almost all frontiers of environment and giving sustainable solutions. The CSE publishes periodicals such as Down to Earth, Gobar Times. It also holds workshops for students, teachers, and other professionals. CSE's Pollution Monitoring Laboratory monitors contamination of the environment. They reported pesticides in colas sometime back. In 1996, CSE reported that air pollution in India was because of outdated engine technology and poor fuel quality. CSE insisted on use of clean fuels such as CNG, also known as compressed natural gas. TERI, another NGO, was established in 1974 with the purpose of dealing with the rapid depletion of Earth's finite energy resources, which are largely non-renewable. Its registered headquarters are in New Delhi. TERI has its branches in North America, Europe, Japan, Malaysia, and in the Gulf countries. Development Alternative is an NGO which was established in 1983 for research on sustainable development, such as developing green and clean technologies. Sustainable development benefits for economy, people, and the environment. Kalpvriksh is an NGO established in 1979. It works for environmental awareness, campaigns, and litigation. It made local protests against the destruction of Delhi's largest green area, the University Ridge. It also worked for Chimko Andolan and impacts of the Narmada projects. Sulabh International is a social service organization which was founded by Dr. Vindeshwar Pathak in 1970. Sulabh's innovations include Sulabh Sachalaya, hygiene on site, human waste disposal technology, construction of pay and use public toilets. The mission of Sulabh International is to make a society free of untouchability, social discrimination, and prevalence of subhuman practice of manual cleaning of human excreta. The process is known as scavenging, and the people doing it are known as scavengers. Untouchables engaged in the profession of cleaning excreta have acquired social acceptance now, and people do not hesitate associating with them. Sulabh International provides human rights for scavengers, environmental sanitation, waste management, social reforms through education. Human dignity is restored to the scavengers by liberation, rehabilitation, vocational training, social elevation, and proper education to next generation. WHO, World Health Organization, the major task is to combat disease, especially key infectious diseases, and to promote the general health of the people of the world. It is one of the original agencies of United Nations. Its constitution formally came into force on the first World Health Day, that was on 7th April 1948. Since environment and health are closely related, in addition to its work in eradicating diseases like polio, WHO is devoting increasing attention to various health environment related issues. To tackle environment related health hazards, WHO has developed Health Environment Link Initiative, HELI. It is a global effort by WHO and UNEP to support action by developing country policy makers on environmental threats to health. FAO, Food and Agriculture Organization, is a specialized agency of United Nations that leads international efforts to defeat hunger. FAO helps developing countries and countries in transition modernize and improve agriculture, forestry and fisheries, ensuring a good nutrition and food security for all. Public awareness of environmental issues in India. Newspaper headlines are communicating to the general public every day about the various environmental issues our country is facing. NGOs such as Center for Science and Environment and legal bodies such as National Green Tribunal are regularly making public aware of environmental degradation. The air pollution status of urban cities is being regularly reported by the above organizations. NGT, the Government of India, established the National Green Tribunal on 2010 under Article 21 of the Indian Constitution, which guarantees the citizen of India the right to healthy environment and makes a citizen aware of their role to keep the environment clean. NGT has passed many laws and orders to keep the Indian environment clean and is making people realize their own responsibility towards the environment. It passed an order to curb noise pollution in Delhi, making noise pollution an offense in 2012. You must have noticed that now during festivals and functions, we are not allowed to create noise by using microphone system after 10:30 p.m. NGT has passed a direction to impose a fine of Rs. 5,000 on individuals throwing religious items in Yamuna River or burning waste and other items as they cause pollution. NGT has also asked the central government to include various parameters such as PM 2.5 and hydrocarbons for checking air pollution. The air pollution control measures started when lawyer M.C. Mehta filed a petition in the Supreme Court in 1985. Regarding the alarming rise in vehicular pollution in Delhi. In 1996, CAC insisted on use of clean fuels such as compressed natural gas. In 1998, the court ordered that all buses in the city must be converted from diesel fuel to CNG by 31st March 2001. World Environment Important Days are days used by the global community to promote and spread awareness about issues of environment significance. Most of the world's important days have been established by the United Nations, and many schools, colleges, and institutes celebrate these days. Some of them are World Wetland Day, 2nd February, World Water Day, 22nd March, Earth Day, 22nd April, World Environment Day, 5th June, and Ozone Day, 16th September. Now, so far we have studied what the government, NGOs, and civil societies are doing to protect the environment. But what can a common citizen like you and me can do to help keep the environment clean and to spread awareness? So we can celebrate World Environment Days, become member of an environmental organization in your city such as WWF, and read environment magazines. In our daily life also, we can spread awareness about not wasting water, using recycled paper, segregating waste, making your school and home environment clean and green. So these small steps taken by citizens can help the country and the world a lot. We should become an environment friendly citizen as our local actions affect the global climate. So we must follow the mantra, think globally and act locally. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Rita Khosla, for sharing information related to environment-related institutions and organizations. Before we wrap up, we would like to recap the main points, that is what you have learned. The role of national government is critical for control on the role of national government is critical for control of environment pollution, conservation and improvement of environment for promoting sustainable development. In 1972, National Committee on Environmental Planning and Coordination was formed that gradually evolved and become a full-fledged Ministry of Environment and Forest in 1985. CPCB is a statutory organization constituted in 1974. Its main function is to monitor, control and regulate air and water quality. CPCB advises central government on any matter concerning prevention and control of air and water pollution. Indian Board for Wildlife is an apex advisory body in the field of wildlife conservation in the country. The international environment agencies are United Nations Environment Programme, UNEP, FAO, WHO. Their main job is to coordinate the environment policies for keeping the global environment under review and bringing the issues to the attention of international community for action. WHO, that is World Health Organization, has the objective as attainment by all people the highest possible level of health, formally came into force on 7th April 1948. Thus, the 7th April is celebrated as World Health Day. FAO, that is Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations, its aim is to modernize and improve agriculture, forestry and fisheries. It ensures food security of all. Commission on Sustainable Development, that is CSD, in June 1992, the landmark global agreement reached for its formation in the Earth Summit held in Rio de Janeiro. It was established in December 1992. Main function of CSD is to monitor the progress and activities related to the integration of environmental and developmental goals by government, NGOs and other UN bodies. United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. The main aim of the convention is to consider what can be done to reduce global warming and to cope with whatever temperature increases are inevitable. Kyoto Protocol is an international and legally binding agreement to reduce greenhouse gas emissions worldwide. It came force into in 16th Feb 2005. Non-government organizations are independent of governments. They are many NGOs that are committed to the cause of wildlife conservation, environmental protection, resource conservation and sustainable development. International Union for Conservation of Nature, that is IUCN, is the oldest and largest global environmental network. It's headquartered in Switzerland. Worldwide Fund for Nature is an international NGO which works on issues regarding conservation research and restoration of the environment. The national NGOs are Center for Science and Environment, Kalpvruksh, Sulabh International and Development Alternatives. Dear learners, this is all about environment related institution and organization. We will come again to meet you with a new program of environmental science. Thank you.